Thank you and welcome. This is FourniLearn. Today, we are going to learn how to display a virtual keyboard and mouse while streaming or recording videos. Most people use OBS, Wirecast, or vMix to stream or record their laptop or PC screens. In this tutorial, we are going to display a virtual keyboard and mouse on both Wirecast and OBS. For those who do not have either of the two installed, you can download OBS, which is free software, from the link provided in the video description below. Make sure to select the right download for your computer, which is Mac, Windows, or Linux. For Windows users, there is both 64 and 32-bit software. Most modern computers use the 64-bit. Go to GitHub and find NohBoard keyboard or use the link provided below to download the keyboard emulator application. Once the download is complete, locate the two downloads. Double-click on OBS to install it. Find the NohBoard zip download and extract it using Windows Explorer, or an archiver like WinRAR. Find the NohBoard.exe application file inside the extracted folder and launch it. After the application launches, right-click anywhere in the blue area and choose Load Keyboard. In the category list, find your suitable category and use the keyboard definition area to choose your preferred keyboard. You can go through all the categories to choose your desired keyboard. Personally, I find wheels useful and I can select from several options provided. For instance, let's select a black keyboard today. When done selecting, you can close the load keyboard options or just launch your desired application. We shall start with Wirecast, which is a bit complicated but great for professional streamers. Right now, I'm already recording my screen with Wirecast, so I will only need to add the keyboard on top of my recording. Select the plus sign in the layers and find the screen capture option on your left. Select New Screen Capture. Under Source Properties, change Capture Type to Window. Drag the other layers down to ensure that the new screen capture is on top. And now it's time to select and configure the window or monitor. Make sure that the All Applications is selected and then ensure the NohBoard window is selected, then say OK. Resize your keyboard to fit your desired size and position. You can even change the keyboard to a different one. To remove the green background, select the chroma key properties. Select Use Chroma Key, and pick the key color with the mouse to be able to select the green color. Key threshold is used to remove the selected color. Press Go to effect the change. On OBS, the process is almost similar. Launch OBS and select the plus sign under Sources and select Display Capture. Choose your preferred monitor to capture. You can right-click to fit to screen. Then select Window Capture, and under Windows, find the NohBoard window. resize and move to your desired location. The up and down arrows in the sources pane can be used to move the layers towards the top or bottom or by using drag and drop. Right-click on the NohBoard layer and select Effects to remove the green background. On the left side, right-click and select to add chroma key. Make sure you select the right color of your background to remove it and then find the close button to close. You can see the transparent background now, and if you type, the keys are highlighted to show what you type. When done using the keyboard, just close it. That's all for today, guys. Make sure you subscribe, comment, and like our videos. Goodbye.